Alrighty guys, another very spontaneous decision. I am now about to sell my car to my buddy Parker right here. And then from there in the car I just sold him, he's gonna drive me to Tesla and I'm gonna lease a Tesla Model X. As I grow, I'm learning all about the tax benefits and how to structure your payments and everything. And it makes no sense to pay for a car full in cash. And I didn't know this. Now I'm going from a car that I'm just losing money on that I can barely even depreciate since it's an exotic to a lease of a Model X, which is more than 6,000 pounds. And if it's more than 6,000 pounds, you can write off a big portion of it. So basically guys, my plan is now that the economy's tanking, I'm gonna take all the money I'm gonna make from this and I'm basically gonna throw it all into the stock market. And I'm gonna make way more money off of not owning this than I would from keeping it. I know it's a hard decision. I love the car, but it's ran its course. I've had it for a year. Now it's time to make much smarter decisions. Plus, honestly, guys, I just want a more practical car. Like, I'm tired of not being able to fit shit in here, having to call my friends whenever I want to buy something like a table or something. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring this over to Parker right now and see what he thinks. All right, guys, made to RP Exotics. About to head inside and see what the dealio is. All right guys, here I am at RP Exotics, home of the best cars in St. Louis. You can come find this place at RP Exotics in St. Louis, Missouri on North Warson Road. I'm here to sell my BMW i8. And while I'm waiting for the bank wire to go through, I'm gonna go ahead and check out a bunch of these exotic cars that they have in stock. Let's see what they got. He said, go ahead and start up some cars. I go, which one's the loudest? And he said, this one right here. Oh my God. All right, guys, look at this. They have a classic 1991 Lamborghini. You know what this car makes me want to do? I want to go pop a bunch of lemons and some lewds, hop in this car and drive it around like Jordan Belfort and then crawl home. There it is. One last ride in the BMW i8. Perfect. COVID. Bump. Thank you. Have fun with it. And so it ends. So many memories in there. The first exotic car, but now it's time to upgrade, so to speak. All right guys, I'm in it right now. I think this is the one. Like, the blue one's cool, but it doesn't have the rims and it has a 7-seater. While this, I really love that space right there. This is the 6-seater. It's a little more expensive, but this only has 2,000 miles on it because this is like the test driver. So I actually get a discount for that. So I think this is the one. Right, so check out this text I just got from Parker. So apparently he left the key with me after he drove off. I know this for a fact because I got my key right here, so. I guess you can drive it without the key as long as you don't shut it off. So he's actually gonna run up here right now to grab the key that he, for the car he just bought. That's so funny.
I guess you know you can drive it without the key.
Yeah. Thanks, man.
Yeah, so I'm in a Model 3 right now. I ended up not buying any car. What happened was, you know, the whole point of me selling my car is to have as much cash to put into the stock market as possible. And since I only have a 750 credit, they said I'd have to put at least 22,000 down when I thought it was gonna be like more like 5,000. So I was like, you know, that's just not gonna happen. It doesn't make any sense for me. And then I started like stepping back and I'm like, okay, it's a $100,000 car that I'm leasing. I don't know if this makes a sense, even though it's half written off. So I talked to my accountant, wait, we're doing it. It doesn't even need to be a 6,000 pound vehicle to get that 50% write off. So then my options exploded. So I'm happy that happened because if they would allow me to put 5,000 down, I would have just bought it. And I would have bought such an expensive car really for no reason. Not really bought, but lease. So they were nice enough to give me this car for the night, allow me to think on it because there is a Model 3 Performance in Nashville that I'm thinking about picking up tomorrow. I don't know if I want to lease or own it. I'd probably go with owning it and just finance the whole thing because it's way smarter to finance a car like that than to pay. I found the hard way. So I woke up, I was supposed to drive down to Nashville to get the Model 3. And if any more things couldn't go wrong, I wake up, I go to fill out the form for the financing, and not only did they spell my last name wrong, but they also put my residential address as this the Tesla place in Nashville. So even one of those things is gonna make an invalid registration. Called up the one in St. Louis, you know, they're like, oh, I'm so sorry about that. They fixed it. Okay, cool. And right before I'm about to fill out the form, I'm like, you know what, maybe I should call Nashville and make sure they even have this car, because St. Louis said they had the car, but at this point you never know. So I call up Nashville now and the lady's like, huh, the VIN number doesn't match any of our fleet vehicles and we actually don't see it in transit anywhere. And I'm like, are you kidding me? So you don't even have it? And they're like, no. So then I call up St. Louis and they're like, yeah, so it says that it's in transit, it's just not there yet. And I was told it was there. So it should be there Monday or Tuesday. And then I just got a call from Nashville. Now they're saying, I don't know why they're saying this, but we don't see that anywhere. We're not supposed to get anything on Monday or Tuesday. So we're going to go ahead and call them. So now they're going to be in communication. I don't know what's happening. It's just like so many. It's just crazy how many difficulties I'm facing just to get this car. It's wild. But yeah, but I'm just chilling. They gave me this Performance Model 3, which is the same one I'm getting. I just got all my stuff that Armin shipped from LA. Shout out Armin. Time will tell to see if I even get this car. Very weird. Very strange. Wow. What a journey we are going through right now. If things couldn't get any more interesting, they just did. So basically what it's saying is every single non-essential business will be closed on Monday. That's a loaner. I have the Tesla Model 3 Performance loaner right now, and the car's supposed to come in Monday or Tuesday, supposedly. What's gonna happen if the car comes into Nashville, but the Tesla location I rented it from isn't in operation? Do I just get to keep the loaner as long as I want? Like, what if I'm having second thoughts or I want to get a different Tesla? I may get to keep the car through the entire quarantine for free. Well, I paid $100. I have no idea what's about to happen or what decision I'm even going to make. But at the end of the day, it's making for a great story right now. Ideally, I just keep the car for the next couple months while Tesla's not even in operation. The location's like, they don't want it. They won't need it back. They probably won't even think to ask me. If Nashville gets it, I might go down there, but if it's looking like I can keep it as long as I want, oh, I might just hold on to it. I guess we'll see here soon.
Alrighty guys, it is now a month after that last clip you saw. If you thought things were going wrong originally when I was trying to get my Tesla, just wait till you hear this update. So I'm actually about to go get my car right now. It's right down the street. About to go pick it up. I just want to put this segment in right here before I go get it, just so you understand exactly all that's happened. I'm going to summarize it the best I can. So essentially what happened was I started becoming very indecisive. I decided I don't want to get the Nashville Model 3 because, like, why would I go get a Model 3 when I just go straight to a P100DU? So, you know, I was tracking the prices on all the P100Ds, and guys, they were dropping by $15,000. Like, these prices are dropping so hard on these Teslas. So I'm like, you know what? I'll just get a P100D. So I ordered those first three Model 3s. I canceled all of those. And then I ordered a P100D. They shipped it all the way here to Tesla. And I said, nah, never mind. They didn't charge me a delivery fee. That's great. And then I decided, you know, I'm going to get a Model 3. I decided to go add another Model 3. They start preparing a shipment. And I said, no, never mind. I'm going to get the P100D. And I don't want this to drag too long. But basically the issue that happened was I submitted three auto loan requests. Those are hard inquiries. Quickly turned into seven because I started, like, I went to Bank of America. They offered me a loan. I'm like, okay, great. After ordering many Teslas, it came down to, okay, I finally found a P100D. It was only $70,000. Everything is perfect about this one, except it's a little banged up and it has a good amount of miles on it and it's more expensive. But in my mind, I was just rushing at this point. Okay, I'm just gonna do it. Again, the whole point of this is to fully finance a vehicle so that I have as much to invest in possible in such a great opportunity right now. So when I finally made the seventh switch from the Model 3 to the P100D, when I went to submit my app for Tesla's financing, for the Model 3, they wanted no money down. It was a 4.5 APR. For the P100D, they wanted $35,000 down at a 6% APR. I'm like, fuck that. Why is this happening? Why is this happening? Come to find out, on my Credit Karma app, it was saying my credit was 760. It's actually 677. I don't know how there can be such a huge disparity, but the reasoning for my credit being so poor, unfortunately, is 1 year ago, my credit was 780. I remember I just hit 780, and all of a sudden I looked at it a month later and it dropped to 670. And I go, no, it dropped to like 656. I remember I was just looking at, like, I've been working so hard to build my credit. What happened was my gym, I switched my credit card at my local gym, but that month's charge ended up going onto that card. So I never paid it. That $12 missed payment cost me 105 points and I've only recovered 20 points from there. So once I realized that, I'm like, okay, I'll just get the Model 3 again. So I submit another auto loan. Oh my gosh, I can't believe this even happened. I submitted another auto loan app, and now we're eight deep. I have eight hard inquiries on my record in like the past couple weeks. So I was in my car, it was ready to go. But then this morning, guys, literally just 30 minutes ago, I had a consultation call with this lady called the Credit Ninja. Shout out Leanne. Leanne has done amazing things with credit, and I called her because my friend Melissa paired us together because I know she is one of the best credit people in the entire world. You can look her up. She's at Credit Ninja on Instagram. What she is doing for my credit is absolutely unbelievable. Like, She's able to remove all those hard inquiries. She's even able to remove that $12 charge from a year ago that tanked my credit so hard. And now she's taken my credit age from 3 years to 22 years. So I'm expecting like maybe a 100 point jump in the next 5 months. That she said it would take about 5 months to do all the things we need to do. And then she's gonna increase my personal credit limit from, I think it's like 30,000 right now. She's gonna increase that to about $250,000. And so she's just doing amazing things right here. But one of the most amazing things she did for me was this morning, I was telling her I'm getting this Tesla, the Model 3. I'm really happy. I'm expecting it to be shipped out any moment. And guys, a lot of people have told me things like, well, Scott, have you ever thought about maybe like getting a less expensive car at like a time like this? Or like, maybe you shouldn't. And a lot of people did that. She went way different than anyone else's. And this is why it resonated so much. She goes, no, do not buy that car. There's no reason you should buy anything expensive right now, Scott. Do not do it. You will regret it. I promise you. I know so many people who recently bought expensive cars just because they're bored during this quarantine and they're crying right now. They are wishing they never would because the prices just keep dropping. She said that car you want is probably going to be 30, 40% off down the road. They're doing tons of repos right now. They're doing A lot of people are getting so desperate. So why would you buy that car right now when you can't even drive it anywhere? You're in quarantine. And something in my head just flipped. She was the first one to actually get through with me, and it made sense. And it didn't come off as someone. She wasn't telling me maybe I should do this. She wasn't telling me what to do. She told me what I had to do. And that's why it really stuck with me. So guys, now I'm about to go get my car, and it's a dramatic shift from everything you've seen in this video. Now, before you see what car I get, I just want you to realize one thing. This whole process has been extremely strange because every car that I've wanted or I've gone to buy throughout this whole thing, I can buy multiple of in pure cash right now. However, the situation that I'm in, both in quarantine and the continual potential decline of the economy, like Leanne's right, it doesn't make sense to buy something like that. There's no where am I gonna go? You know, there's no reason for me to do that right now. Furthermore, that's gonna lock me into a multi-year deal at a bad APR, when if I just wait 5 months to buy something cool that I really like maybe a Tesla or something, she's gonna repair my credit in those 5 months. A shout out to her. And then the last thing I want you guys to realize is the car I'm about to get right now and those other cars I was talking about, I weighed this decision between many people I know. And what's very interesting to me is the people who were like not that successful are kind of successful, maybe making like a couple $100,000 a year. All of them told me, yeah, bro, get that car. That'd be so badass. Get that car. Don't get anything. Well, my most successful friends, I'm talking tens of millions, potentially hundreds of millions of dollars in net worth, all said, conserve your cash right now. Now is the time. Do not get the car. Get something cheap. You won't regret it. You're setting yourself up right now for generational wealth. You do not want to spoil it. So it comes down to, do I want to listen to people my age who are making just a couple $100,000 a year and listen to their advice? Or do I want to listen to people 20, 30 years ahead of me making tens of millions of dollars a year and listen to their advice? I'd rather be like them. So without further ado, let's go pick up the car.
Guys, I finally got my car, a 2018 Toyota Camry. Now I got an insane deal on this. So this actually only has 8,000 miles on it, 2018, and I got it for $17,000. I fully financed the whole thing, $0 down. So now I have maximum money to put into the stock market, 4X or really whatever I want. I had no plans to buy this at all until this morning. This deal was so beautiful because now I'm gonna be driving the fuck ton. Watch out for a ton of new travel videos coming up. I'm thinking about taking this up to Wyoming actually this weekend because I wanna put a ton of miles on here. This is not gonna depreciate as much of the value as it would maybe the Tesla Model 3 I was gonna get. So by buying this car, it puts me in the exact position I wanna be in where my cost of living per month just 10x lower. The insurance on this is also 8 times cheaper than my i8, and it was 10 times cheaper than the P100D. And the car payment on this is 4 times less than the Tesla. It was a really weird experience going through this, but I'm just trying to be more and more financially responsible than I was when I first started this channel. And especially at a time like now where we don't really know what's gonna happen with the economy. We don't know what's gonna happen with car prices. We have no idea. We don't know how long we're gonna be quarantined. And that much uncertainty, I do not want that heavy burden of owning an expensive car. Now I'm at the point where I've seen for myself and experienced myself, money makes money, but you gotta keep that money for that money to make the money. And then lastly, it was just like another weird thing that I was going through mentally was like,
I've kind of felt this tremendous pressure to keep up this image of being a successful e-commerce entrepreneur. Like a tremendous pressure. That's why I was just rushing to get a Tesla. And I'll end this video with this. It is so weird to me that 2.5 years ago, when I was driving that 1999 Honda Civic with 200,000 miles held together by duct tape, just embarrassed to drive it, all I could think about is like, damn, I wish I could get one of these cars. And it was this. It was a 2018 redesigned Toyota Camry. And I remember thinking about that so much. I just want a Camry. Oh, if I got a Camry, I'd be so happy. I'd be so happy. Because now I'm in a position where like, this is a massive downgrade from what I'm used to driving, which 2.5 years ago would be a massive upgrade. So it's all about perspective. It's all about perspective. So many things just kept going wrong. An incredible amount of resistance against buying a Tesla. I'm probably just gonna hold on this car 5 to 10 months so I can see like what happens with the economy, what happens with car prices, wait for the exact right one I want, all while my credit's being built up so that when it's time to pull the trigger, I get the best rate possible and save the most money. I will say I'll probably begin the P100D in like 5 to 10 months. Either that or the NSX. So guys, let me know what you think about that ideology in the comments below. Be sure to like this video if you made it all the way here. And just thank you guys so much for watching all these videos. This car is gonna be in a lot of videos to come, especially these road trips I'm gonna be going on since I don't wanna fly anywhere. Be sure to subscribe. Peace out. I'm like, just so glad I don't have to worry about getting a car anymore. God damn.